I think that's a very key fact, and I'll make it clear again. If we are have got trust, and the trust isn't with the public, then if someone is seen from the outside, then they're not tainted with any of the trust issues and things going on. So that, I think, is something that's caused with that person who done the independent report. I don't know yet whether we've prepared reports on this and have new information. We went to power last year. But what I do know is that with all the hindsight that you have said and all the things you claim to have known, and that would be interesting to see some of the information Councillor Mavis referred to and the dates upon those. If you were 100% sure, then the action should have been taken in your year of tenure. The actions weren't taken, and almost by default, the actions weren't taken. No one was disciplined. No actions were taken. The Martin report reported on, and you dealt with that report that was generated by the previous administration. Nothing actually happened. Martin Moore did not get his job back, and Martin Moore still hasn't lost his job back, despite being offered his job back. I have no direct opinion on the Martin Moore square back to be voting. That will be Martin Moore's issue. But all we have got is an action plan. It might not be a perfect action plan that you've got offers to embellish and make better. Particularly picked up what idea Jeff was talking about, is whether if the employees don't trust anybody in your organisation, whether it's an independent person who reignites, gains that trust. What was very difficult in this circumstance is when Castle Hill, which you referred to, and we made it quite clear from the chief executive and the leader and the deputy leader of their administration, that's the constitutional administration. We said quite clearly, people should be in this organisation, put their head above the parapet, say what they feel, get issues out in the open, and it should be dealt with properly. We made that quite clear. We encourage that in everyone who made their speeches to members of staff, we encourage that to happen. And my reward for that was to get the ball to the sack. Thanks, okay. That's life, that's politics, you can deal with that. But what we've got, certainly what we've got, is an action plan. We have got an action plan. All Councillor Kelly, I have to say, when we launched the action plan and all the key lines required, every single member was invited to engage in every single key line required, and some key lines required went in the lead of politicians who went later. So it was an attempt to be open and inclusive. So we've got a whole host of detailed recommendations. De facto, they will go because we're called in, so de facto, they are part of the action plan and may well be encouraged by the new administration. If you think it's the right acknowledgement, then we would certainly not call him in. So, we endorse that. So how far does that go to endorse the action plan? Will it succeed in changing the culture of staff and politicians? I don't know. It's a start. Will we start considering the normal on will actions that aren't considered proper behaviour everywhere else? I don't know. I hope and pray that we will move forward. We list a number of bits in the action plan that have been agreed and a set up according to government's report. We put them in place, the action plan is there. And then those lines were like, the approval board didn't say stop doing that way, by the way. They said, prioritise, come back with us, and we will help lead and guide, and that's the next stage. But what is sad, what was very sad, is the corporate plan, again, we delayed the corporate plan because we wanted to make sure that the corporate plan of this authority took on board the issues raised in the Anna Kornowski report. And through the machinations of the politics within this chamber, we've ditched the corporate plan, and the corporate plan we've adopted is last year's, which was printed before the Anna Kornowski report. So we have missed a golden opportunity to enshrine the NKA lessons and learning of our corporate governance in a corporate plan. If nothing else, that is an opportunity that's been missed. And the corporate plan, of course, will feed through to the department and service plans, and hopefully it will be. And the draft corporate plan, which we've reverted, we've got the information there. We've put the resources in our budget to make sure that that happens. Now we see that the proposals of the new director of adult social services, who has none of the issues, none of the baggage that he brings, many of the officers may have as a result of what's gone on in previous years, comes and puts his recommendations forward. Also in the action plan, I hope you do take note, that we are strengthening the safeguarding team. Just as when we inherited your budget and the loss of staff, I said, if you've got problems with it, I'm a big lad, big broad shoulders, I can take